Hello, dear friends. How are you? We're starting a new week, and I would like all of us to take a few minutes to set up our mind and our consciousness for the coming week. In Hebrew, it's interesting, the word love in Hebrew, it's the same, it's four letters, like in English. And what's interesting, there's the name of God called the tetragrammaton, which is four letters. And the name love is very similar in the letters to the tetragrammaton. So we're actually using in Hebrew the word ahava. In Hebrew, in English, we can just use the word love. But the idea is basically, I would like to take the time every day, and right now, all of us together, to, through the word love, to generate the love of God through us, to be channels of the love of God. We know that the love of God wanna share his love. And from our point of view, there's two things we need to focus on. On one hand, to receive the love of God, to accept the love of God, to be open and to desire the love of God to enter our life. And from the other hand, to desire to channel through us the love of God to others, to actually every human being. That's kind of the main two things that a person should be busy with. To draw the love of God and to share the love of God. And it's also important to take the time to actually meditate on it, to focus in it, because that we know that our mind is a channel for the light of God. So when we're thinking about it and we're thinking about sharing the love of God, it's actually allow it to be revealed. Same way that if you turn on the light in a dark room and the darkness goes away. If you just share the love of God, just thinking about a person or a situation or a place, you basically reveal the love of God, and that's by itself already creating the magic. The same way that we don't really understand how the light in a blink of an eye pushes away the darkness from the room. It's a magic. The same way, if we're dealing with any kind of situation, not just ourselves, somewhere in the world there's darkness, feels like darkness. All what we need to do is just to turn on the light by thinking about that person, that place, just send the energy of love, and the magic will happen. The darkness will be removed. Not just that the darkness will be removed, as the Zohar says, the idea is to transform the darkness into light. And that's why it's important to take the time every day to meditate, that we actually sending the energy of love to every corner of the world. That's our responsibility, and that's also our duty. So let's do it together. What I would like all of us to think, just to think about the word love, four letters, L-O-V-E. In Hebrew, it's Ahava. If you're familiar with the Hebrew letters, Aleph, Hey, Bet, A. If not, it's also okay. We also have the tetragrammaton, which is four letters, Yud and Hey. In Vav and Hey, we can also channel this energy if we're familiar with these letters. If not, we can just focus and concentrate on the word love. And just start to think about, first of all, receiving love, as we said before, to open ourselves to receive the energy of love. From God. To allow the love of God to enter our life, our thoughts, our consciousness, our soul, our body, our reality. And we'd like to generate this energy of love through us, to others, and to every corner of the world, to every human being of the world. We would like to start to think about people, that we would like to send them the energy of love. We can start, first of all, from the Middle East, from Israel, from this whole region, from Gaza, to send light here, to send love. We know that it says that Israel, especially Jerusalem, is the center of energy for the world. We'd like to send the energy of love, that there's going to be peace here and harmony. And of course, we would like to send the energy of love to every country of the world, every human being of the world. We'd like also to send the energy of love to our parents, to our husband or wife, to our children, to our siblings, to our family, immediate family, extended family. Just meditate to share the energy of love. Try to think about other people in your life. Basically, every person that is somehow connected to your life. Send them love. Just think about their face for a second. Just send them love. You don't even need to remember their name exactly or anything else, just to visualize them for a second. Send them love. Just by doing that, turning on the light in their life. The light of love. The light of love is a magical thing. It's the thing that basically heals everything, fix everything in the best way possible, bring joy and happiness and blessing to everything. So all what we need to do is just to channel the light of love through us to every corner, every place, every human being, every person. We would like to ask from the Creator to give us the strength that everything that we're going to do today, and it's important to do this meditation every day if possible, that everything we'll do today, we will have the merit to generate the energy of love. Every person we'll speak with, everything we'll touch, or everything we will be in contact with, we will be able to generate the energy of love to every human being, to every soul, to every person, to talk to every human being with love, with kindness, with care, with compassion. And in the same way, we would like to let the light of love to enter inside us, to fill ourselves with love, with kindness, with mercy, to feel the love of God, and to generate of the love of God. The same way that we breathe in, breathe out. That's how we should live our life. We let the love of God in, and we share the love of God outside. And we let the love of God in, and we share the love of God outside. The same way that we're breathing like that the entire life, without stop in such a beautiful circulation. That's how we want to start to breathe in a spiritual way the love of God and to breathe out the love of God. We'd like especially to take the moment, to take the time to send love to the people in our life, to our spouse, to our children, to send them special energy of love. And to be the people that we care about, to really send them right now energy of love through the letters love, Ahava, Yud Kevavki, Tetagrammaton. Also, we'd like to take the time to think about the people in our life maybe we'll not exactly get along with. Maybe you have some kind of friction with them, something in the energy not exactly working in the most perfect way. And we want to think about them and to send them the energy of love. We want to be able in the same way to be receptive of the energy of love. If people want to share with us love, we open to receive from them the energy of love. And even if they don't know exactly how to share love, we still open to receive from people because we know that within every human being there's a lot of love. So we open to receive. We want to thank the Creator for the endless love that He's sharing with us, and also thank for the opportunity to be channels of love, of the light force of God to others. Thank you, God. We want to bring all this love back to God. All this beautiful feeling that we feel. We want to share it also with the Creator, this warm feeling. And with every human being in the world. So every human being in the world will be able to feel the love of God through us, and to open their heart as a result. Thank you very much, everyone. I would like to wish you a good and blessed week full of love. And Be'ezrat Hashem, God willing, that we will be able to reveal a lot of light and a lot of love this week in the world. Shavua Tov. Have a blessed week.